Last week, over 300 South Sudanese students from Kampala University Juba campus protested after they discovered that their names were not on the graduation list after traveling from Sudan for clearance. Today, the students led by their guild president, Oyiki Sirino, dragged the university to court over the matter. According to Oyiki, the students fulfilled all the requirements and paid for tuition, but they were surprised when the university management said it did not know them. They add that the university has been graduating students since 2017, and it's upon this that they wonder why management says it closed the university in 2017.
And we wonder if it now is telling us that it doesn't know us. Yet actually we fulfilled all the requirements, we paid all the clearance fees as required by the university. And if he said he suspended operation in 2017, but why actually graduated a student in the same 2017 and 2018, 2019 until 2021? And what I know, there are actually the resolution that came from his state house in 2018, which is stated, Katerega, who is the Vice Chancellor of Kampala University, should graduate a student from Juba who were due to graduate in the March 2018 graduation held in Kampala. Two, issued a transcript and certificate for the student who graduated in March 2017. It strengthened the work relation between the main campus and Juba campus by opening the communication channel. To leave the suspension, which was for one semester, 5 to June 2017. That was issued by the VC, Professor Katerega, after some misunderstanding from VC.
Last year, the same happened, and when our student pay money, he cleared them. So if we came and we accepted to pay 4 million each student, nothing of this would have happened. We would have been cleared and would have been graduated. But we will feel inside our heart that we bought that certificate. We did not earn it. We came with our receipts. We paid all eight semesters. We paid them. And we came with our academic clearance and ever provisional results. Normally, these are the process that we did officially. And now, after all this, you need to put them aside and say, bring me 4 million, I graduate you. This is not the business we want.
Derek Tumusime, their lawyer, stressed that his clients need to graduate and stop the graduation ceremony to take place unless they're put on the board.
Today we are here together with the students from South Sudan of Kampala University who are enrolled in different academic programs and have over the time been studying at Kampala University Juba Study Center. They are aggrieved following their failure to be considered at the 19th graduation, which is going to be held on the 23rd. They have decided to bring their matter into court so that court can hear them out on grounds that, first of all, they qualified, they met all the academic requirements, they have paid their tuition in full, and they have also cleared the same. The allegations that the institution was closed are false, and therefore it has no iota of any law behind it, and therefore we are asking court to stop the graduation, allow them to be considered for graduation.
Yes. Yesterday, the proprietor of Kampala University emphasized that the students from Juba campus won't graduate because the campus was closed. Meanwhile, the principal of Kampala University Juba campus in South Sudan, Faizo Juko Kalema, has dismissed claims by the university vice chancellor, Professor Badru Katerega, that the branch was closed.
They were expressing their anger. Bobali Balaga in a peaceful way.
They were only holding placards, showing dissatisfaction in the matter. I wish the VC could come out and talk to them as a group rather than getting second-hand information. Professor should sit with the Juba administration to clear this mess. I don't really know why VC thinks this group is so violent and are planning to cause havoc on the D-Day.
Kalema has also disassociated himself from allegations that they were planning to interrupt with the university graduation. Report by Shamshad Naluja for the news.